think about the heart as the engine of a car and the coronary arteries as the fuel lines. So the moment that there are blockages in the coronary arteries and the heart demands more fuel, more blood, it's not able to receive it. Coronary artery disease, it's a very complex process of fat accumulation and inflammation in the wall of the coronary artery. The final aim of what we want to do treating coronary artery disease is to prevent a heart attack. Once a patient is diagnosed with coronary artery disease, some patients are essentially managed in a conservative way with guideline-driven medical therapy. Now, there's a big category of patients that would benefit from stents or a bypass operation. With a bypass operation, we take blood vessels from somewhere else in the body and we sew it to the heart. We build a detour for the blood to get on the other side of the blockage. Traditionally, bypass operation is done using the heart-lung machine, which is a system that does the job of the heart and lungs when we stop the heart. We have to open the chest, and then we have to put a big clamp across the aorta to disconnect essentially the heart from the rest of the circulation. So the rest of the body will be perfused by the heart-lung machine. We stop the heart, we stop the lungs, and then on a still heart, we find our targets and we sew our bypass. And then we restart the heart. Now, this is a great operation that has very good short-term results, but has some shortcomings. Using the heart-lung machine changes completely the physiology of the patient for that hour or two that we are working on the heart. This can have a deleterious effect on the kidneys, on the lungs. There's a higher risk of neurologic injury, which can be a stroke or a cognitive impairment of some sort with the use of the heart-lung machine. Using quite sophisticated bypassing technique, is possible to do the entire operation without touching the aorta. So what we call anaortic bypass. Because the coronary arteries are on the surface of the heart, it's not compulsory to have to stop the heart to operate on its surface. So with the off-pump bypass or beating heart surgery, we use specific instruments to stabilize a portion of the heart where the target of the bypass is, and we let the heart and the lungs working normally, function normally for the entire operation. And there is a very strong advantage. The patient, they essentially have a much less of an inflammatory process to fight during the recovery. The other advantage of using advanced coronary surgery technique is to use more arterial conduits. Our blood vessels are categorized in two arteries. In veins, artery bring blood from the center to the periphery. Veins bring back blood from the periphery to the center. Artery are exposed to a high pressure. Veins are exposed usually to a very low pressure. So if you use a vein to deliver blood to the heart, over time, this high pressure stress on the wall of the vein will essentially build up and they will block off. There is a very large body of evidence that shows that the more arterial grafts you use, the better the benefit for the patient on the long run. Not only in terms of having a risk of more chest pain or another heart attack or having to have another procedure done, but also a survival benefit. At Yale, we embrace this culture of offering the best therapy for our patients. For every single patient, there is a discussion that takes into account the specific of that individual. So the therapy is delivered in a very individualized, in a very personal way. The anaortic off pump gives the short-term benefit of avoiding a stroke and the long-term benefit of using arterial grafts so that the patient doesn't have to come back for another operation. The aim is to fix the coronary artery disease once and forever with one operation.